There we go. The up smash. My God. That up smash. That up smash though. Took out his first stock at 70. I think Ice Climbers has a giant advantage here because of the fact of the two characters. Even though they can't do their signature wobble. Well, there goes Nana. Nana! No! Oh, nice bear. This is off to a great start for Pink. Forward smash. Deals a lot of knockback, 17%. Down air, barely catches him. She really has no kill throws, that's the problem. The kill potential on Sheik is a little bit lower than expected. Yeah. Here comes Ice Climbers. Yeah. But now Ice Climbers are back to full strength. Ooh, they almost read the roll. Ooh, nice shield. Ooh. Side B. Oh, the D-Sync. Oh. Nice. Yo, Pink. The Ice Climbers, right?
Yeah.
Hey. Get the name right. Yeah. Right there.
What did he throw?
Oh, 51% already from 13 seconds in. Good. Oh no, Nana!
Oh,
The problem is, I think ice climbers get a huge nerf to them when there's only one of them. Because their up B doesn't cover that much distance. Oh, it covers like probably the height. No, it's probably the height of. No, a directional air dodge goes higher than a single ice climber's recovery. Yeah, the real only kill potential that Sheik has is up air, up high in the stage. Or just like that, back air, or up smash. All of the smashes are, ooh. All of the smashes are really strong. Although the one least used is most likely for its smash. Real pressure. Oh! And Nana was a little too far away, so the recovery didn't work. Lunchbox down to 2 stocks. Could go anywhere right now.
What the fuck is that?
Oh, forward smash. And, back throw to back air? Back air to forward smash. Alright. Lunchbox takes game 2. Battlefield. Still going with Sheik. Still Ice Climbers, alright. First game went great for Ice Climbers, second game went great for Sheik. It's actually a pretty good track. Reminds everyone of the glory days of Brawl. Days where Meta Knight was still overpowered. He sings. Nobody is safe from the desync. Nice spot dog. The up tilt to up air. So did the attempt fail? Oh, Nana's gone. Oh. Beautiful spot dodge. Nair. 130, 150, nope. Over 100% for both players? Nope. I think up tilt's kind of like an anti-air. I say an anti-air because mainly that's what you use it for. Oh, just barely. Up tilt probably kills around like 200%. I would not be surprised if any of them got to that percent.
There you go. First off, taking off of game three.
And back to the neutral. She sucks for both and 0%. Boom!
Up air to up air. Backing up that damage.
Oh my god!
Whoa, okay. The ledge options on that were so minimal.
That was way too close.
Nana, what are you doing? Nana, what are you doing? There? That up air is really deadly. No! Seek 152. Whoa! Unexpected hitbox on the up B.
Let's go, pig!
Oh! Holy hell! Wow! Pink, that was fucking sick. That is like... Also... Oh! On Green Hill Zone, nonetheless. Totally illegal. 26% with a double fair. What? Poor Nana. Is that shenanigans? Up tilt. Well then. Karma strike back. That's how it starts. But Live and Learn is a banger though. That's perfect. Dim the lights. Oh, Nana! No!
Wow.
Really? Yeah. Actually, one game away from Orisa. No. Oh, the shield. Charge right in the face. No, Nana! Unfuck 6, game 4. Alright, either it's Lunchbox winning this or Pink get the reset. Sticking with Dark Samus. Oh. So you switch to Palutena.
The counter pick.
Explosive flame. Oh. That's 0 to death, man. Learn's just, it's a good song, it's just, such riveting music. Just short of reach. Auto reticle. Oh. Ooh. Oh. Explosive flame into up air. Lunchbox takes it.